First, I would like to thank respected chair, Dr. Rajesh ji, and other dignitaries. I also thank all the delegates, those who are here for this 2 days conference, because they are the really they are doing the vocational education major shift from the policy to the implementation. That is more important in any policies programs. You, most of you are involved in this activity. I would like to congratulate all the those who are dealing with this vocational education. I am from National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration. In this presentation, I would like to try to link vocational education to higher education. This outline of this presentation, first national priorities in education, either all levels, including vocational, advantages for India, what is the advantage we are now in the world, what are the achievements so far we have tried from the last 5 decades after independence, but we are not able to achieve that much, but so far what achievements we have done. Identification of the need gaps. What are the gaps, particularly in this area of vocational education to higher education? Solutions pertaining to India's economic growth. How you have to plan for the future. And some of the suggestions and conclusions I would like to read that. Before that, in India, particularly for those who are in here from other countries, these universities contribute significantly to sustainable development by linking knowledge generation and knowledge transfer to development concerns of the society. That is the one of the major responsibilities of the universities in our country. Creation of productive employment for all is a necessary condition for reducing inequalities. If you see the India, there are a lot of inequalities, regional inequalities. You can see the social, economic. Access to professions is regulated by education and skills. Access to and success in higher education influence access to jobs and income distribution in the present context. Any inequality in the distribution of opportunities to pursue higher education will encourage unequal access to jobs and will result in income inequalities. If you are not giving the chance to go for the higher education, if you are creating the inequalities also in the income distribution. Equity in access to higher education and skill formation as necessary paths towards better jobs, improved well-being, sustainable development. If you see, most of the speakers also mentioned about the demographic dividend in our country. We already mentioned about this. 54% of Indians' total population is below 25 years of age. Even the youth population in India is expected to increase to 350 million by 2022. This is the projection. The average age is 29 years. During the next 20 years of labor force in India is expected to increase 32%. Youth in the country are equipped with employable skills and knowledge to enter the workforce through quality education and training. That is our motto in this coming years. If you see the present scenario in that, India is in third place after USA and China in the enrollment in higher education institutions. Number. Increase in number of institutions but not able to improve the quality of higher education since independence. In most of the states, they increased the number of institutions in higher education institutions. Even if you see most of the software companies in the world, Indians are heading those companies. Microsoft, Google, if you see, even most of the people, they are going abroad, or most of the Indians to the USA. Another advantage of this country is the English language is very important compared to with the China. They are not able to reach to the software because of the language issue. But India has the advantage of English-speaking people. Another important issue is the multicultural background is an advantage to work in the different countries. Most of the teaching posts are vacant in Indian higher education institutions. If you see, most of the 46% of the positions are vacant. They are working only in the ad hoc or temporary or contract basis. This is one of the disadvantages for the higher education in India. If you see the recent developments, most of the initiatives taken by the central and state governments in the area of Skill India Mission was launched in 2015. India has launched the scheme on skill development based higher education as a part of college and university education. This is one of the major developments in these last 5-6 years. Even establishment of the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship is one of that. Even Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana, these are the programs recently launched by the center. The Skill India program is the outcome-based skill training schemes for the youth to make them employable. This is one of the initiatives. Another important thing is the developing qualification framework to link education with employment. That is NSQF. Community colleges, most of them you are here in the working in the community colleges. I am not going to the details of this. There are some gaps in our education system. No link between education and employment in our country from the beginning. If you see, those who are studying in the graduates in the colleges and the universities, they have no plan, no goal. That is one of the major setbacks. Economic growth rate is less. Unemployment is very high, if you see. Unskilled manpower, agricultural productivity is very less, to be solved through research in higher education. R&D is also one of the major setbacks in India. We are not spending much funds to R&D compared with other countries like America 2.8%, China 2.1%, and Israel 4.3%. We are spending only 0.6%. This is one of the major issues. We have to allocate more funds to the research and development in higher education. One of the important issues I would like to raise here is the 90% of the educated youth also don't have this digital literacy. They don't know about much about this.
Last 2 minutes, sir.
Okay, sir, thank you. Even one of the important issues is the teacher-student ratio in higher education is 1:30. If you see in the USA, that is 1:12.5. In China, 1:19.5. This is the teacher people ratio in the higher education. Even if you see the one of the major recent developments in higher education in engineering graduates, they are not employable. Most of the 60% are unemployed. Even most of the colleges, engineering colleges, most of the states, like Andhra Pradesh, they are closing down because of there is no admissions. That is one of the major setback quality of education is concerned. There is a lot of interventions in the field of vocational education through apprenticeship programs. Even the national education policy also talking about the changes in the higher education system through vocational streams. Even government is also thinking to start national higher education qualification framework for higher education also. That is one of the major. If you take the best practices in other countries like Norway, Finland, Switzerland, Denmark, and Germany, these are one of the, we have to learn from them, even learn from the other states, those who are doing it at the local level. even if you see the youth ready for skilled jobs, most of the countries like UK 68%, Germany 75%, and South Korea 96%. But we are very low, now maybe increasing. One of the major challenges is the linking the skills indicated by NSQF with the teaching learning process in higher education institutions. This is one of the major issues. Community colleges, Bachelor of Vocation degree programs, knowledge upgradation centers for skilled human action and learning. We have to reorient orientation of the content and process of higher education that is more important nowadays. Addressing the challenge of the rapidly changing world of work, we have to change our vocations also time to time. Enhancing employability of students by making higher education more job oriented. Equipping students with the knowledge and skills, including soft skills, not only vocations, but soft skills also we have to. Required to respond to the needs of changing demands of workplace, labor markets, and the fast changing economies. The criteria for assessment and accreditation of higher education institutions include periodic renewals, curricula to enhance focus on employability, entrepreneurship, and skill development. Every 5 years, you have to change your curricula. Integration of cross-cutting issues relevant to environment and sustainability, human values, and professional ethics into the curriculum. Integration of transferable and life skills, including core vocational competencies and soft skills. There are different lists of the soft skills. You have already have this. But one thing I would like to integration of vocational education in the last slide, if you show. Vocational education as an integral part, last slide. Integration of vocational education is vocational education as an integral part of the larger vision of the holistic education. If you think about this, our Indian history, our vocational education integrated into all secondary and undergraduate education institutions in a phased manner over the next decade. Focus areas chosen based on skills gap analysis, mapping of local opportunities, capacity and quality of teacher preparation to be addressed. This is one of the important to improve the quality of vocational and higher education both. National skills qualifications framework detailed further to each of the disciplines, vocations, and professions. Lok Vidya, knowledge developed in India, made accessible to students through integration into vocational education courses. Even within the country also, we have different states, they have best practices going on. We have to share those best practices to different, that is one of the major initiatives, like this institution, we have to do that type of doing this innovations to give some competitions and showing this type of presentation is only this much, sir. Thank you.